So what are the different ways you have done the image recording, and what are the issues you have faced while doing image recording?
For that we have used Scrape Relative. So whenever we are extracting data from PDF, we need to give a lot of trial and error for increasing the scale.
Okay. I understand that you have worked most on the PDF activities and PDF automation. Have you worked anything that is related to virtual machines or anything that is related to remote desktop automation?
Yeah.
Okay. So there, what have you used? Have you used image-based automation?
Citrix.
Okay. In the Citrix, I think you should be doing only image-based automation, right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. What or how resolution will play an effect in Citrix automation or image-based automation?
In Citrix-based automation, resolution will give many issues. If you add, suppose your test machine and production machines are different, then there will be a resolution issue. So you can do one thing, you can use that text screenshot activity, and by saving that image, you can check the resolution, and as per that, you can set it in your machine, or you can either use it in orchestrator, because in latest orchestrator, we have option to set the resolution for particular robot.
Correct. So you were saying that we can set that particular robot and we can continue to edit.
Yeah.
So did you face any some issue where initially did not provide you access for their machines, and they asked you to work on image-based automation, but later they were not satisfied with the results and they have provided you access for the machine and they have installed UiPath in that? Did you have any such scenario?
No.
All the data is completely in image-based automation and you have done that?
Yes.
Okay. So how many times the bot may fail while doing the image-based automation?
It depends actually on the what kind of images or what kind of application. Based on that, we can analyze that.
So what kind of applications in the sense?
Java application or any other application. So based on that, because if anything, suppose you are opening anything URL, and suppose if you refresh, it gets it, every time it's changing after you refresh.
Exactly.
And based on that, we can analyze all those things.
Okay. So are you aware of estimation plan and how do you do the estimation plan?
Yeah, so actually we used to have some standard templates. So based on your requirement, you have to mention your activities. So based on that, there will be three standard categories, like simple, complex, and very complex. So if you use for simple, it will automatically give you hours. If you enter complex, then it will give you an hour. So after the end of the estimation, it will give you total hours for the development.
So here I have a question. See, the data that we fill is also a manual thing to do, right?
Yes. Yeah.
So, how reliable can that be? Did you find any scenario where you have said that this is a simple process? Later, you came out saying that, okay, this is not very simple process and we need to change the estimated time.
Yeah. Yes. No, really, as such, I have come across this situation.
Okay.
Yeah, but if it gets changed, then we can ask for more time also. No, if it's UI changes or code changes are again, then we need to provide more estimation again.
Okay.
So how you are making estimation?
So we are also doing the same thing, but what exactly we do is we'll first initially do a POC. Before giving a complete estimation, then depending upon the POC, if we found any bottlenecks, then we'll go back to the business and say that, okay, these are the bottlenecks. First, we need to clear those particular scenarios, or we need to first standardize the process. Then we'll go with complete estimation plan.
Okay.
Okay. What are the different scheduling methods that you follow in the orchestrator?
It depends. If it's too much complex, then we have to use a cron expression, but it's simple like hourly, weekly, monthly, then we can schedule. We have option in Orchestrator for that. But if it's suppose on every alternate day or some days in a week at every time, then exactly. We need to write a cron expression for that.
Okay. So can we discuss deep in Orchestrator?
Yeah.
Sure. Thank you so much. So what are the different ways you find out a particular process or transaction is giving you proper result, or a particular process it's giving you a proper results and it's not failing too often? What are the different ways you will find out rather than going into the logs?
We can then check with the expected result and actual result. So based on that, you can find out whether it's running successful or not. Or else we can provide some screenshots or email notifications as well.
Okay.
So that it will give you, if it's success, then it will capture the screenshot. If it's error, then it will capture the error screenshot.
So normally, how many times will you retry a particular transaction?
3 times.
Is it an industry standard, or if the business requires you to try for more, then how will you do it?
Yeah, we can retry till 20 times, I guess. So,
okay.
But no one will go for that more. I have not seen anyone that it's use more than 5 times retry.
Okay. So let's say that a process, you have clicked on some button, but the process takes a bit of time to give you the output. Not every process gives you an instant result within 1 or 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, without retrying, how will you make sure that the bot wait for the next run?
Yeah, we can use some activities like element exists or image exists. So once okay. that comes, then we can proceed further.
So normally element exists will have, what is the timeout for element exists in a normal scenario?
30 seconds.
Like if we can increase it till how many seconds? Let's say that we have increased for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay. So even after 5 minutes, my bot didn't give, or my process didn't give me the exact result that I require. But according to the business scenario, it should not retry, but it should wait in that particular case without failing. So do we have any activity to do that, or how we can exactly do?
We can go with delay, but I don't think so that it's best way to handle all those.
Okay. So any other way?
No, I'm not sure for this.
Okay. Maybe we can try retry scope.
No, but it should have also time interval as well. So if it's loading after 5 minutes, then till how much time you can wait?
So let's say that business gives you an option. Okay. Don't make it retry or make the transaction fail. Make sure at that point you wait and retry there itself for 5 times or 6 times, rather than completely making the transaction retry, make that particular particular activity or particular place where the bot is taking more time to retry multiple times, so that it waits for the result. In the retry scope, yes, there is a interval where we need to give, but if we keep the interval as zero and if we give multiple retries, then it will not wait for too longer time. And we can also check with the Boolean expression or is match expression in the condition state to check if the element matches or element exists.
That can be done with element exists or image exists as well.
But it cannot retry.
Okay.
Okay.